Right, hello. Let's get cracking on these DS lights. So, this one, hinge has gone and it needs a new top screen. So, let's get it apart and see what can be done. Don't need a pen there, don't need these there. Where are my other tweezers? Right in front of me. Always plenty of DS light screws on this desk. Over there. Now before I take all of these gubbins out, oh no, I can just do the screen on its own, can't I? Yeah, no worries. And go there. This is coming out. Come on. Handy, we've got one just where we want it, right there. Now let's get these little bits off. Such a nuisance. Useful. This can get chopped because that screen's coming out, and that'll make it a little bit easier. Just pop that out of there. replacement screen. Okay, we'll have to go to the other room and get the big box. Right, that's a few of those sorted. So before we continue, let's just scribble on them. Right. I'm not going to write another one because I'm now going to use it. That would just be daft. Let's get the top. Peel all this off. Gone on nicely. Okay, pop it back out and then we'll get these speakers removed. And fitted. On the top, red on the bottom, black on the top, that didn't work, did it? Nice. Red on the top, black on the bottom. There we go. Feed that round the back. I don't know why, because it's now about to fall out as soon as I attempt to put it in the case. Stop that from escaping. Come back here. Curl up the old ribbon. Get these around that cable. That's better. Now to pop it out and retrieve that speaker. Hope I haven't ruined it by being a little bit too rough putting it in. I've just put this back in the old case. Absolute idiot. What an absolute idiot. I've just put it back where it came from. What an idiot. So, let's try that again. Yes, you can all laugh along at home. All right, put that to one side. Retrieve a new one. Fit all right. No, that does not seem right. Should really go in further than that. See if we can get it in a bit further without breaking anything. I'm probably going to say no. See, that's kind of that. Can't have that at all. See if I can find a different one of those. Easier to start with, wouldn't it? Muppet. with that. Yeah, funny how that works when you put the right size bits in. Right, don't quote me on this, but we should be all right to put it back together now. Should. It's a miracle, all four of them are still there. I managed not to lose any of them like I normally do. probably should have stuffed this in before trying to put it together. And that's not even the right hinge for a DS light. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Box of spares. That one should be right, I hope. Does it fit in there? Yep. There we go. Back in. Somehow. Right, let's put two screws in to hold this board in place and see if it powers up. If it does, I can nip it all back together. If it doesn't, I can just go off and sulk. Power's on, lovely. So let's put it back together. And that will be number one sorted out. One. Two, volume down, power switch down. Let's put the little volume switch back in here. There we go. That's in the down position, and so is that. Right, that's all the Phillips heads back in. One, two, three of those. Battery cover. Slot 2 cover. Let's power it up. Get through all of this. And now let's see if it needs to come back apart again to do the touchscreen calibration. Beep. Beep. Lovely. One, two, three, four. Superb. So that's number one. Sorted. Right. Well, I'll just take that off. Fixed. Magic. Right. Let's find the next one. Right. Let's have a look at number two. So the hinge is knackered. That is scratched up. And the cart reader doesn't read. So let's find a crap old game. Maths trainer, that'll do. Douse it in that. Have a look. No, the pins look okay. Okay, we'll charge you up. I better plug it in first. So the cart reader is knackered, and the hinge. Oh, I need those. I hadn't popped them back in the last one. That's that sorted. Let's get back to this. Unfortunately, I don't have a top mid-frame in silver to replace this one with, so it's going to get a black one. So it's going to be a bit of a custom DS light. Touchscreen off, because that's too scratched to leave on there. It's an absolute state. So that can come out. That can go there. Now I do want to be careful with this top screen, because it does work. No point replacing something if I don't need to. Is that going to come off? Yeah. That'll clean up all right. Okay. With my tea. that rolled up nicely. That's out. Now where's the other one of those? Well, let's get this one out of here. Those little side pieces out, and that can go in the bin. There we go. There's a screen. Right, that's nicely in there. I quite like the look of that black and silver. I'd quite like it a little bit more if I had not been an idiot and had put all the right bits in. Mug. Back out it comes. Not only that far. Just to put the microphone. I'll try that again. whole thing off. Not so keen on that. It's like a Well, let's get it together, see what it does, and if I had to take the screen out, I can do that whilst it's got the back and the board in. Because that could just be air in the system. But I didn't notice it there before. Was it? I needed to get a new touch screen for it as well, didn't I? I'll go and grab one of them. Right, give me a couple of screws. I want to see what this looks like. Still needs the cart reader doing, doesn't it? So once we've seen that the top screen works, I'll have it back out and a part to do that. So I'm not going to put these in properly. I'm just going to make sure it looks the part. And we'll put these in properly. I can't believe I forgot to do the cartridge port whilst we were here. Oh, they can stay out, that can stay out. Charge up. Yeah, that's not gone to plan, really, has it? In a mullered screen, brand new but somehow mullered. Let's take all these screws out. Top off. Oh well, right, I'm going to leave that because maybe it did actually need a whole new screen. Who knew, hey? Who knew? Tomorrow's another day. Right, let's delve into this a bit more. It's had some time to charge up. Either it's all got to come out or I've not put that cable in properly. No, that cable's in properly. It's just broken. Oh well, it's got to come apart anyway to replace the cartridge port. But now it's a case of cart port swap, top screen swap, hinge swap. It's just more effort than I really can be bothered to do on a Friday evening. I should really, by all rights, be down the pub. Right, heat that up. Let's have some. You know, I've not actually swapped the cartridge port round on a DS Lite before. I bought plenty of them to replace, but haven't actually replaced one yet. So this will be a first. I mean, it's just going to be the same as doing a 3DS or 2DS or DSi. But let's get this old one removed. Where's the old solder sucker? Right, now to start on the pins. In the bin for that one. There's the old thing. As I think I have dislodged a tiny little capacitor here. Which I have. And it looks like the pad was gone. Let's get that off of there. This is going to be fun. I need to put a blob of solder on it. don't think that's going to stay on there. Okay, change plan. This I've had enough of. I'm just going to put a working board in that shell and swap the top screen around. So, fuck that. Excuse my language. On the soldering iron, because these are going to need to come off whilst that heats up. Get a new top screen. Down here, I'm going to put this new cartridge slot in that little bag, and I'll put that away later, but for now it can sit there. Peel that off. Stop sticking to my fingers. Exceedingly sticky, sticky thing. Well, that's not really worked. Let's try it again. Third time lucky, perhaps. An instant fail. Let's have a look here. Right, that seems to be in the right place. Good, that works. Now, let's get this on. Binward bound. Let's get this lovely new screen in. And hope that this kink in it doesn't cause us any problems. I am apparently failing at this today. Good. Once this is together, this top section, I'll have a look and see which one out of the pile is the most mangled up, and that will be our donor board. Right. Hang on a minute. I don't need to go and find a donor board. Well, I don't need to find one. There were some boards that came with these, so I'll retrieve one of those and see if any of them happen to work. That will save stripping down one just to take the board out. Two secs. Let's try some of these. Pins look okay. Does it accept and spit out a cartridge? Does it turn on? No. Let's get the cable. So it charges, but won't turn on. Okay, well, we'll ignore that one for a second then.
Next. Next.
Missing the power switch.
Next.
Missing the power switch and missing the cartridge port.
Next.
Power switch is knackered. Well, none of them are any good then. So they are literally just to take parts off. I don't know what this board's for. Oh, no. That one doesn't charge. Oh, well, on the pile of boards just for spare parts. Oh, I've got this one. Doesn't switch on. So it doesn't charge. Well, let's have a quick look at it. That one's half sorted. Just need a motherboard to go in it. if this is something simple like a fuse, we can have one off one of those and we'll be in business. I don't know why I'm pulling it out. I want to get the multimeter out first. Set it to beeps. Fuse 2. Fuse 1. So, I don't know why that doesn't charge me. And I haven't got time to pee about with that, so back in the box. Next. Top screen's faulty apparently. Leave that to charge for a minute. Alright, what's it saying? Power's on. Top screen's mullered. It's got volume. Yep, yep, yep. Come on. Please read a game cartridge and I can take this motherboard out and put it in the other one. Brilliant. Right. This one's getting stripped down and we're using it as a donor for the silver and black one. Mid frame of this is going to get used for something else another day. I'm going to build another red one at some point, but for now let's just get that silver and black one flipping working. Those pads weren't cleaning up. It's screen's good. Right. Lovely bit of a corrosive muck on there. Where's the baby wipes? Ever so handy, these things. And while we've got it open, let's have a bit of IPA in the L&R buttons, because they do get a bit grubby and they don't always work properly. So just work that into the switches a little bit. Yeah, that's good. Right. Fit this lower screen with the new digitizer on. Happy days. Slowly ease that in. Nice. Get this out of the way, slide that in, and I'm going to put two screws in just to make sure it powers up. Does as it should, and then we'll get it together. I'll put the wireless card on first, shall I? Idiot. Excellent. Right. Let's get this back together. In a minute, once the back is on. going to be a nuisance. Oh, this is hopeless. There's not enough tensile strength in this cable. Let's try it with a bit of gravitational force. There we go. Stick this one down. Help if my hands weren't quite so cold. It's freezing in this building. They turn the heating off at the weekends, but then it's only me that comes in at work, so they're not going to heat a whole building for little old me. Right, what have we got here? We've got the other one of those. Get the volume switch in. Down, down. There we go, that's on nicely. The volume's working, power switch is flicking. Right, that was a bit of a bodge because obviously we've just only replaced the motherboard rather than fixing the cartridge slot, but that's my own fault for pulling what looked like a capacitor or a resistor off from under the board and pulling a trace off with it. So it would have just been so time consuming. I might as well just use another machine that was already knackered. Get these top pieces back in. Not that they want to fit. So it goes in outside. There you go, right. There we have it. Number 11 should be back to life. Run through, just make sure it's still reading cards, and then I'll have a look at number 11. What am I about? Number 2. Number 11 is the PSP video. You can tell I'm working on too many things at once. Happy days, Junior Brain Trainer Maths Edition. Right, excellent. Let's pop that one away and get starting on the next one. I'll give that a clean in a bit. Right.